Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, as we are continuing our CRUD application for products which we were inserting. So as you saw that in previous video, we have inserted the image and stored into a database, right? And now guys, what I want to do is that we will fetch the images and its data stored with that. Okay, so guys, let's get started with it. As simple, which we have created a product URL where we have fetched this user interface, right? So let's go to this page, and over here we will design a table and fetch the records of it. So as you see over here, we are on the index page. Okay, so this is the page where we are seeing the output. So let me just tell you the product data. I will just give now, let me say products data. If I refresh, you can see that we are in the current page. Okay, so this is products data. And now guys, let us implement the design for that. So I'm using Bootstrap 5, so you can just follow up with that. Table dot table bordered, and inside this t head, where table heading, where table row, inside this table row, table heading I'm going to call, that will be one is ID, and then second will be the product name, and then the price we will call, and then finally the image we will call. Okay, we don't need description. So as you see over here, we have four columns, which is about name, description, price and image. So I don't want to call description because it will be too long. So I'm going to call only name, price, image and one ID. So if you required, you can call this also created at. So let's call that over here. If you required, keep that, or else just ignore. Let's keep action one for edit and delete purpose. So let's get down over here and tell t body. So this will be the table body, not table, t b o d y. Okay, t body will be there, and inside this table body we have to call the loop for it. So before calling loop, let's design that table data where you are going to send one, and let's print this 111 for testing. Okay, so first four and the final one will be your action. So inside this I'm giving a link over here where edit, and one more option will be delete. Done. And guys, now let's assign a class for this. Class is equal to where inside this button where I'm going to give success, ESS, button spelling is missed over here. Let's give button success, and let's copy this and create a class for this also, where I'm going to give class is equal to where button, which will be danger, D-A-N-G-E-R. Done. And I wanted to add one more thing, this button to be small. So let's add button SM, and inside this also button SM. So let's refresh and see its user interface. Let me just refresh. Cool. So this is how our data is looking. So now let's fetch this detail, whatever we have done here. So let's get back and code it. So first step, we have to go to this route, which product. So let's copy this and search into your routes.php. So over here, you can see that routes folder, URL is found here. Let's go its product controller at index function. So let's go to product controller over here, and here is our product controller at index function, and let's pass the variable for that. So let's create a product variable, or products is equal to where you are going to new keyword, where you are going to call your model, product model I'm going to call, and this product is actually products, we have already created that. So include at the top, make sure you are having a products model. So if you don't have, please create a product model like this. Okay, so with the help of this, we are taking all the datas here to product table name and the primary key and your allowed fields for it. So let's get back to our controller, and you can utilize this, call your path of your product model, and then call that over here. So guys, now after this, let's call this over here. So let me give data variable over here, and we have to tell this as products, where you are storing what you're going to store, this products variable. So this product variable you are going to use find all. Okay, so find all is one function from the codeigniter given. So let's pass this data values, and then let's pass that. Now inside this index page, you can access this data. So inside this, what and all you have stored, products you have stored. So let's copy this products thing and go back to your index page. And over here you can write for each loop. Okay, so we need to write in PHP. So let's open PHP and close PHP, and let's type for each, where I'm going to give colon, and we need to end the for each loop. Open PHP and tell end for each and give semicolon and close the PHP. So you are giving colon over here and final end for semicolon. And let's pass that variable which you have copied now, products, as dollar item we can tap. Okay, so let's take this item and we have to call it over here. So let's make a shortcut of PHP open and echo. So this is equal to will work as echo. Okay, and let's print that variable called dollar item. Inside this dollar item, you're going to print ID. So let's save this and see the output of it. So let's refresh. Okay, cool. So that means you are getting one correctly, data has come. So let us just same way, you have to fetch all the data about it. So let's just remove this other things and let's just paste with that. And now over here, okay, let's call that name. And over here, what you're going to call the price. So according to your table columns, you have to fetch. And the last one will be image. So let's save this and let's refresh the page over here. So guys, now we want the image to be fetched, right? So we don't need the link. So let's call the path. So as you saw in our controller, where to store the image. So let me move to our controller. You can see while storing the data, we have called uploads folder from the base directory. Okay, public folder. So from public folder, you have to call that. So you can call, go to your index.php and call the path of it. Okay, so let's call this. So let me just cut with this. And here I'm going to include img tag, where image tag will be there. And over here you can tell image in this alt and the path you have to give over here. So as simple, let us paste this and we'll be concatenating in this. Okay, so how will you concatenate the path of it? So we have to give into double quotes, where I am going to assign that uploads folder. Make sure you are having that uploads folder where I'm storing the image, and inside that folder I'm going to give forward slash and then concatenate the value. So that is the item of image. Let's save this and see the output of it. So before seeing, I will set the height and width of it. So let me give height is equal to 100 pixel, and width also I will give. Let me just close this sidebar, 100 pixel. Okay, save this and let's see the output of it. So let me just refresh. Okay, so you can see that image is coming perfectly. So let me just add one more image for it. Okay, let me just choose the image first and see the, let me add Dell laptop over here. Let's tell Dell laptop, and for description also Dell laptop description, and price will be 130,000 we'll give, just for example 30,000. Let's click save and it goes over here. And product data and image saved. Cool. So you can see that it's coming fine and perfectly working. So guys, this is how we are fetching the data of the image. Okay, data and image. So guys, see you in next video about how to edit this image and data and update the image. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like and share.